In this video, we will discuss about ideal transconductance amplifier, the input impedance and output impedance of an ideal transconductance amplifier. So this question is very common. It has been asked in GATE 2017, GATE 2014, GATE 2007 and GATE 2006 as well. So ideally the input impedance RI should be as large as possible or infinite. Also, output impedance should be infinite or as large as possible. These are the characteristics of a transconductance amplifier. That its both input and output impedance should be ideally infinite or as large as possible. Transconductance amplifier is also called as voltage controlled current source amplifier. Voltage controlled current source. It is also called as voltage controlled current source amplifier. Its feedback topology is current series. Current series, current sampling series mixing. Current series feedback topology is used here. Current series feedback topology is also called as current voltage topology. Current sampling, voltage mixing. It is also called as series-series topology. Series sampling, series mixing. These all are name of the same topology. The current series feedback topology is also called as current voltage topology, current sampling, voltage mixing, or series-series topology, series sampling, series mixing. These all are names of the same topology. So the transconductance amplifier must have infinite input impedance and infinite output impedance. It is also called as voltage controlled current source, and its feedback topology is current series or current voltage or series-series. These all are same. These are name of the same feedback topology. So this is the our transconductance amplifier. Because when we use current series topology, then RI and R naught input impedance also increases and output impedance also increases. This is about current series topology. If we use voltage shunt topology, then RI also decreases and R naught also decreases. So the transconductance amplifier must have infinite input impedance and infinite output impedance. If we have a trans resistance amplifier, for a trans resistance amplifier, R, I and R, O both should be as low as possible. Ideally they should be 0. R, I, R, O should be equal to 0. As low as possible or 0. This is the trans resistance amplifier. Trans resistance amplifier uses voltage shunt topology. Trans resistance amplifier uses voltage shunt topology. Transconductance amplifier uses current series topology. Current series topology is also called as current voltage topology.